Hello, 6th standard student. In last video, we already have studied about our second chapter, that is whole number. And in this video, we are going to solve our first exercise, that is exercise 2.1. And you have to solve this whole exercise in your mathematics notebook. Look, in this video, you can see whole exercise, that is 2.1. I know that you don't have your textbook, but with the different websites and and you will get your textbook online. Now, without wasting our time, we are going to start to solve our first example. The first one, write the next three natural numbers after 10,909. So, if we have to find out the successor of a given number, we have to add 1. So, we will get exactly next number, that is 11,000. If we add 1 to that given any number, so we get the next number, that is 11,000. Okay. Now, what will be the next number of 11,000? That is 11,001. What will be the next number of 11,001? It is 11,002. So 11,000, 11,001, 11,002 are the next three natural numbers after 10,999. Now our second question is, write the three whole numbers occurring just before 10,001. If we have to find out the before number of a given any number, we have to subtract 1 from that number and we will get the exactly before number of a given number. So, we are going to subtract 1 from 10,001 and we will get here exactly 10,000. So, what will be the just before number of 10,000? That is 9,999. What will the next before of number before? Before number of 9,909, that is 9,908. Do you get this? These two questions, these are very easy. Now the third question, which is the smallest whole number? This question is very easy. The answer is 0. Okay. How many whole numbers there are between 32 and 53? Okay, there are many ways to find out the how many total whole numbers are there. As we can count 33, 34, 35, 36, 37 up to 52. Because we are not going to count 32 and 53, because they ask how many whole numbers between 32 and 53. So we have to count this only between numbers. But already in the last video, we have studied about the patterns observation. So, we can set our new pattern. So, instead of listing that, we are going to do, we are going to minus, subtract 32 from 53. That is 53 minus 32. Already we have discussed about this question. We are not going to include 32 and 53. So we are doing here minus 1. So how many numbers I will get here? That is 23. Okay. Now again we are going to count. Okay. With the help of your fingers you can count it. Look. 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52. Exactly 20 numbers. But it takes lots of time to do such a counting. So instead of that, we can do or we can set our pattern. Okay, now the fifth question. Write the successor of. Okay, now already we have studied, if we find out the successor, so we have to add 1. So, what will be the answer? What will be the successor of 24,40,701, that is 24,40,702. Okay, this is the successor of a given number. Okay, what will the answer of this? The question is, we have to find out the successor of 1,199,000. So it, the successor of 1,199,000 is 1,200,000 is a successor. What will be the successor of 10,99,909? If we add 1 to that number, we get 11,00,000. So successor of 10,99,909 is 11,00,000. What will be the successor of 23,45,670? If we add 1 to this number, we get answer 23,45,671. So it will be the successor of 23,45,670. Question number 6. Write the predecessor of. For find out the predecessor, we have to subtract from the given number. So if we subtract the 1 from 94, we get here answer 93. So it is the predecessor of 94. What will be the predecessor of 10,000? Absolutely correct. 9,999. What will be the predecessor of 2,08,090? Okay, very good. 2,08,089. Very good. Okay, you have to now find out the predecessor of 76,54,324. After subtracting the 1 from this number, we get the answer 76,54,320. So it will be the predecessor of a given number. Okay, students, these 6 questions are very easy and you can solve it easily. So in each of the following, you have pairs of a number, state which whole number is on the left on the other number on the number line. Also write them with appropriate sign between them. So look at here carefully, dear students. Already in the first video we have seen that we have studied that smaller number is always appear on the left side and bigger number is always appear on the right side. Okay, in this first question, 530 is bigger, so it appears to the right side of the line, and 503 is a smaller and it appears left side of the line. So 530 is greater than 503. Okay, the next question, look at here, 370 is bigger, which is appear on the right hand side, so it is bigger than 307, and 307 is appear on the left hand side of the line. The next question is 98,765. And the second and number is 56,789. Okay, so 56,789 appears at the left hand side and 98,765 appears at the right hand side. So 98,765 is bigger as compared to another someone. So I will put here this marking. The last question of this question 7. Now we have to compare 98,30,415 and 1,23,001. So we know that we know that 1 crore is bigger than 98 lakh. So I will put here such marking as like this, because 1,23,001 appears on the right hand side and 98,30,415 appears on the left hand side. So this question 7, you can also solve this in your notebook very easily. Students, you are very clever, you are very brilliant. You can solve this all these examples. Just you have to try to do it. Okay. So question number 8. Which of the following statements are true and which are the false? Okay. Look at here carefully. 0 is the smallest natural number. Oh, 0 is not a natural number. Natural numbers are counting numbers that are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It doesn't consist 0. So this statement is false. 400 is the predecessor of 399. No. 400 comes after 399. So it is a successor, not a predecessor. So this statement is also false. 0 is the smallest whole number. Yes, absolutely correct. It is the smallest whole number. So I will write here T. 600 is a successor of 599. Yes, 600 comes after 599. So this answer is also true. Okay. All natural numbers are whole numbers. Okay, now listen carefully. Huh? Natural numbers can be listed as a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And whole numbers are listed as a 0, 1, 2, 3, 5. That means whole number consists 0 and natural numbers. That means all natural numbers are whole numbers. So I am going to write here T because it is a true statement. The next is all whole numbers are natural numbers. No, 0 is also a whole number, but it is not a natural number. So this statement is wrong. So I will write here false. Okay, the next one is the predecessor of 2-digit number is never a single digit number. Predecessor means what? The before number. Okay, if we can going to consider the smallest 2-digit number is 10, and if we have find out the predecessor, we have to subtract 1 from 10. So 10 minus 1 is 9, and 9 is a single digit number, so it is a this statement is false. So they wrote here never, but it can be possible. So I'm going to write here true. 1 is the smallest whole number. No, because there is a 0. So 0, I have to write here false. Huh? So first is small. 1 is the smallest whole number. No. 0 is the smallest whole number. The next is the natural number 1 has no predecessor. Listen carefully, huh? The natural number 1 has no predecessor. natural number counting as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1 is a first number, so it doesn't have any predecessor. If 1 is considered as a natural number, then so this statement is true. So I will write here true. But what about the next? The whole number 1 has no predecessor. No, because whole number are listed as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1 have a predecessor, that is 0. So this statement is wrong. So I will write here false, that is F. The whole number 13 lies between 11 and 12. No, because 13 comes after 12. It is does not lies between 11 and 12. So this statement is also false. So I will write here F. The whole number 0 has no predecessor. Yes, correct. Because when we are going to list the whole number, 0 is the first whole number. So there is no any predecessor of 0. So this statement is true. So I will write here T. The successor of 2 digit number is always a 2 digit number. Look at here. The smaller 2 digit number is 10. I have to find out the successor. So I will write here plus 1 and I will get answer 11. So look, 10 is 2 digit number and 11 is 2 digit number. But what happen if we have find out the largest 2 digit number, that is 99, and if I have to find out the successor of this 2 digit number, I have to add 1 and I will get answer 100, which is a 3 digit number. So this statement is wrong. So I will write here false. Dear students, do you get this exercise 2.1? Okay. So without wasting your time, just solve in this your notebook. I know that this exercise is very easy and you can solve it yourself. So solve in your notebook. And in the next video, we will solve our exercise 2.2. Okay.